these panels have these tabs on them that you can knock out right here. So there's one there for half inch sheeting, one for 5/8 sheeting. That'll hold it proud of the wall enough so that when you put your sheeting on, it's the right amount. So stick it up there like that. Figure where you want it. And then you should be good to go. So I'm gonna get a little ladder so I can look up there and set it where I need it. Now I don't want it to be too tight down here where I wouldn't be able to get out with anything, because that's gonna be some of the ways we come out. The power's gonna come in. We'll come out the bottom for some and run that way. So I want to give myself a little bit of room, but I don't want to be too high where I can't reach everything. All right, so I'll pull this panel off, drill my hole through the wall on the outside. I'm either going to use an auger. If I have a hole saw that's the right size, I'll use that. There's the bit coming through. So luckily, we're right in the middle of a course on the siding, so it's going to fall perfectly. We'll drill that hole there. Thank you.
All right, so we got the weather head on. And the wires run to those bars there. Pulled my supply line through the conduit. This is the 200 amp size. This is gonna go to this panel here, or to this breaker here. The house is just 100 for now, but it has the ability to be 200 later if they want to. So it's got, this is a 400 amp meter base. So I'm gonna cut these and hook them up.
This should be set up just right, so when we remove this power, this can just slip right into that hole and replace it. I'm gonna run these wires long for now, connect them to the base. That way when we call for inspection, it'll all be ready to go except for this last part. And then when the power company comes to disconnect the old service, connect our new service, all I'll have to do is keep the breaker off, run these wires into the panel, and be done. Neutral, A phase, B phase. Take these out just like we did before. No power hooked up. And it's off, and we're gonna get some no C's on here, whatever it's called. No lock.
right, so we've got all our wires coming out of this LB here. That'll be ready to go up into position there once we remove that power here. We've got our grounding strap or wire. So number four coming in here, and I'm just gonna use a crimper and crimp it to this other number four that exists and goes down to my grounding rod.
Thank you for watching, and for more, click like and subscribe. I've got a lot more videos coming up as we progress along in this ADU series, and then moving on from there, we'll have a lot more fun stuff to offer. So follow along, thank you.